Blackstone Publishing presents What the Other Three Don't Know, a novel by Spencer Hyde. This book is read by Erica Sullivan. For Brittany, My Bright Star. Stories of life are often more like rivers than books. Norman MacLean. 1. My mother once told me that when a star implodes, it can shrink to the size of a wedding ring and still weigh 2,000 trillion tons. That's what I thought about as I turned her wedding ring in my palm before dropping the necklace beneath my shirt. I felt the weight around my neck, the cold silver chain it hung on. My dad left us 10 years ago and is now commercial fishing somewhere off the coast of Alaska. My mother died 2 years ago rafting the Snake River, though her knowledge of physics didn't keep her from that sink. 17, parentless, ill-fated, no win, cursed. Call it what you want, they were gone. And I was still kicking rocks and living with Grandpa in a trailer the size of a nickel in a town the size of a postage stamp. Tetonia, Idaho. Population, 300. Just outside the bustling town of Victor, population 2,000. Two of those people in Tetonia were an old man and his jaded granddaughter. The old man was my grandfather, Aldo Lutz, the town mortician in Victor. I'm the granddaughter, Indiana Indy Lutz. My parents named me Indiana because I was born on the roadside next to a weathered, warped green state sign that read, "Now leaving Indiana." I'm sure they had no idea how prophetic that sign would be. Everyone left me. At this point in my life, only a hero could save me, and I wasn't the hero type. I couldn't save myself from the dark thoughts, the quiet moments of guilt and loss, the manic shouting into the ether that everything had been taken from me. Wherever I went, something felt like it didn't belong. But more and more, that something was starting to have my name. My face, my life. I leaned against the hearse parked in front of our trailer. We didn't live in a funeral home because, with so few people in town, we only needed a small space for cremation or prepping bodies for viewing before they went into the ground. It wasn't necessary to have an entire house dedicated to the whole pageantry of death. Plus, the spectacle of grief was more than I could bear. I wrote on the back window of the hearse with my finger, ghosting the words into the collected dust. It's not you, yet. It's me. And then I walked around the side of the car and wrote something else on the passenger door. Dead inside. Usually, said Grandpa as he stepped out of the trailer, pointing at my message. Thankfully, Barry will be the only body in the back today. He patted Barry's head as the giant Bernese mountain dog trotted alongside him. I looked at our old trailer, the siding curling away in places, a drooping front porch, and the small windows reflecting light back onto the landscape. The trees towered over the trailer and rained leaves in the fall, so much so that we used the same shovel in the fall for the leaves as we did in the winter for the snow. Some nights, I'd sit under the giant ash trees and watch the stars throw themselves in bright arcs and fizzle out into black. I used to stargaze with Mom. She would tell me how we were just a tiny speck on a giant map of billions and billions of galaxies, each one filled with those little burning lamps overhead. She said that Aristotle talked about the stars like they were just a grouping of crystal spheres on some crankshaft. I shouldered my duffel bag in what was a surprisingly cold summer morning. It had been a heavy clouded winter and a no-clouded summer. The branches of the aspens swayed in a morning breeze. The sun emerged, throwing long shadows in front of Grandpa's rattletrap truck. I wished we were taking the truck instead of the hearse, but the hearse was better for long drives. As if there weren't enough rumors about the old mortician and his granddaughter. Grandpa walked to the car and yelled at me to get in. I stared back at our little stamp of earth we called home as the hearse rose over a ridge and dipped past other homesteads. Barry nuzzled my arm before situating himself in the back seat. We drove through the spanning shadows of the Teton Mountain Range.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.